Well, hallelujah! It is fantastic and super elastic to link up and sync up once again with my fellow fiends of super groovalistic post-funkstication. I am Scott Dr. GX Goldfine, longtime disc jockey, music journalist, author of Everything Is On the One, the first guy to funk, and host of the Truth and Rhythm Show. Connecting with you on this frequency to lift the curtain on my picks for another down and dirty dozen of the deepest, stankiest funk tracks of all time. In deference to the greatest of all time, Muhammad Ali, ain't no floating like a butterfly, it's all about stinging like a bee. With round five coming at you, packing another barrage of devastating knockout blows. Since we began this jubilant journey together last year, I've bombarded you with 48 glorious groovathons. And since our last funky encounter, I've been itching to put the twitch back in your hitch as we flip the switch to raise the party sitch to 6-0. On the reel, from my heart, I thank you for tuning in to get turned out as we ride the rhythm together. As a reminder, and especially if you are new to this series, like a Surgeon General warning, mainlining funk is extremely habit-forming. Stroking the pleasure centers of your brain, penetrating your soul, sending shockwaves throughout your body, and planting a satiated grin on your face. Once hooked, you will find there simply is no substitute. But relax, it's okay. No need for the FDA or other intervention, because this is the good Dr. GX right here to assure you that the funk is among those rare vices that is healthy, healing, and fully endorsed to become hooked on. The truth is, if you've caught most or all of these shows, congratulations are in order for being a funky junkie. The 12 rump shakers locked and loaded for you this session rank just behind the previous 48 selections. Or I've stated before, a la Parliament's Dr. Funkenstein character referencing his arch nemesis Sir Nose Devoid of Funk, on another day, these tracks could have easily been the ones chasing the noses away. To continue to keep things hopping and popping, I observe some qualifiers for this fifth oral adventure. To qualify for this show, chosen tracks must have been released or charted as a single when originally released. As before, no artist may appear more than once, and the previous 48 are eliminated. In this way, the series emphasizes the breadth of funk artists and wealth of super bad jams. So before you say, hey, what about? Know that if a high-level funk act like Sly Stone, James Brown, Parliament, Prince, Ohio Players, and so on isn't heard in this episode, is likely because they appeared in parts 1 through 4. The lineup you are about to encounter is sequenced chronologically and spans from 1974 to 1983, a 10-year period of funktastic fury. It is a given that the selection process involves subjectivity, which is all the more reason I'm honored to serve as your sonic curator. After the show, please reach out and share your feedback. But for now, I'm going to take you to the holy water, make you drink. Because without a doubt, this nasty funk is sure to make an epic stink. To get us started, trumpeter Donald Byrd has always had a keen ear for talent. The jazz legend discovered Herbie Hancock in the early 1960s and, a decade later, as a college instructor, organized six of his students at Howard University into a band he called the Blackbirds. It was named after his then-recent hit fusion album called Blackbird. Helping their chemistry was the fact that half of them had played together in a high school band called Second Stage. Realizing immediate success under Byrd's tutelage, they remained full-time music majors at Howard, juggling academic demands with recording and going on the road to perform. The Blackbirds proved themselves to be masters of jazz funk fusion, but also demonstrated catchy compositional sensibilities. The group released six albums from 1974 to 1980, scored a movie, toured with artists like B.B. King, Mandrill, and Roberta Flack, and produced hits such as Walking in Rhythm, Rock Creek Park, and Happy Music. While it was their third album, City Life, that received the most notoriety, my choice as their pinnacle of funk can be found in their 1974 self-titled debut album. This deceptively loose cut perfectly captures the atmosphere of a sweaty, late-night house party, where a fella has maybe indulged in a little reefer, maybe some drink, and this irresistible groove knocks him out of trying to look cool on the sidelines to saunter over and pull some fine honey onto the packed dance floor. Man, I miss those days. With its group vocal and call response chants, crowd noise, and thrilling melodica, the persuasive Do It Fluid, written by Byrd, flowed to number 23 in the R&B chart. When it comes down to it, who doesn't like to party? Our next track comes from seemingly an unlikely source, a decidedly non-funk artist who never came close to delivering a groove as deep as this one. On the other hand, maybe it should not be too surprising given this singer's chameleon-like propensity to change and challenge audiences. In fact, one of his biggest hits was called Changes. English singer-songwriter and actor David Bowie was a groundbreaking music figure regarded by many as one of the 20th century's most influential musicians. Particularly acclaimed for his innovative work during the 1970s, his career was marked by reinvention and visual presentation, and his music and stagecraft is said to have had a significant impact on popular music. In 1969, he notched his first hit with Space Oddity. Then, after a period of experimentation, he reemerged in 1972 during the glam rock era with his flamboyant and androgynous alter ego Ziggy Stardust. In a radical departure from that sonic palette, Bowie teamed with Carlos Alomar and John Lennon on one of the biggest hits of the mid-1970s. Speaking to his dissatisfaction with the pitfalls of stardom, Bowie credited Lennon for the energy and inspiration for the song, which was propelled by Alomar's unforgettable rhythm guitar riff. From its tension-building opening, Fame uncorks a relentless, hallucinatory trip into the synaptic recesses of funkitude. The groove was so powerful that later in 1975, as Fame was reaching number one on the pop chart and number 21 R&B, James Brown released Hot, I Need to Be Loved, 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 with the main riff being a blatant retread of Bowie's now classic. Ain't that something? How many of you out there are aware that Roger Troutman and his brother, Lester, could be heard cranking out of boomboxes in nightclubs several years before Zapp's More Balance to the Ounce became one of the monster funk jams of all time, and of course previously being featured in this series? Formed by multi-instrumentalist producer, arranger, and composer Byron Bird in the funk hotbed of Dayton, Ohio, with a steady stream of albums and singles for Capitol Records from 1976 to 1984, Sun faced an immediate problem for its debut: an incomplete band. To fill the hole in its rhythm section, Bird recruited Roger on guitar and bass and Lester on drums for the studio sessions to finish Sun's first album. Upon its release, the album was originally named Live On, Dream On, but when an incredibly infectious track broke out as what would become the biggest hit of the band's career, the record was later reissued bearing the single's name. Anchored by talkbox embellishments on his hooky chorus that would become the hallmark of Zapp's and Roger's sound, Wanna Make Love, Conflict My Bic cashed in on the Bic disposable lighter's buzzy slogan. As the perfect anthem for concertgoers to turn on their lighters during shows, this up-tempo banger peaked at number 31 on the R&B chart. It's time to light that fire. If you ever dreamed of how mind-blowing it would have been to hear Chaka Khan fronting Funkadelic, first off, you're not alone. Secondly, we can all enjoy the closest approximation to what that heavenly pairing might have wrought. Formed out of Atlanta in 1970 by singing married couple Joyce Kennedy and Glenn Murdoch, also known as Baby Jean and Doc, Mother's Finest is considered by many to be the original black hard rock band, blending funky rhythms, heavy rock guitars, and powerful soul vocals. The group developed a loyal live following while notching gold-selling albums and hits like Fire, Baby Love, Don't Want to Come Back, Love Changes, and Piece of the Rock. Despite that, Mother's Finest likely would have been even bigger had they not often found themselves in no man's land where it came to radio play, faced with racial bias at rock radio and rocking too hard for black radio. But to their credit, they stuck to their musical vision, even when it meant more acceptance and touring overseas. Having recently marked their 50th anniversary, the band continues to perform today. In fact, I caught them this summer, and they continued to deliver the goods. In my view, Kennedy, who as a solo artist in the mid-1980s had a number two in R&B hit ballad duet with Jeffrey Osborne called The Last Time I Made Love, is underappreciated as one of the top female vocalists of her generation. Listen here as she elevates the fiery Truth Will Set You Free to the apex of funk, rock, and church.
Oh,
Founded by supple-voiced singer Frankie Beverly in Philadelphia in 1970 under its original name of Raw Soul, this group relocated to San Francisco and was introduced to Marvin Gaye, who took them on the road with him as one of his opening acts. In 1976, Gaye suggested they change their name, from which point Mays would go on to release 9 gold-certified albums from 1977 to 1993. While Beverly and the frequently changing personnel of Mays became best known as a top-tier live act for their mellower affair, like Happy Feelings, While I'm Alone, Golden Time of Day, and Joy and Pain, they also proved themselves adept at funky soul, like Southern Girl, Back in Stride, and Working Together. The choice here for their greatest funk track dates back to Beverly's Raw Soul days, with its updated recording featured on Mays' self-titled debut. With stirring lyrics and a chorus that begs the questions, what color have you colored peace? What color is harmony? Colorblind takes off with a pulsing wah-wah thump and organ punctuations. And yeah, it is tragic that its words could have been written yesterday. Thanks to Beverly's raspy growl, the message in music resonates and rattles the listener deep in their bones.
Radio may be keeping the legends rich, but at Modern Retro Radio, we're keeping them relevant. Keep it locked here on Modern Retro Radio.
During the height of P-Funk's late 1970s empire of multiple acts signed to different record labels, George Clinton decided it was time to give Parliament Funkadelic's female backup singers some light under the sun. While the first to appear was the trio Parlette in 1977, a year later was the Brides of Funkenstein duo that realized the most airplay and sales success. Previously background singers for Sly Stone, Don Silva and Lynn Mabry joined the funk mob in the mid-1970s before being tabbed as the femme fatales to Clinton's infamous Dr. Funkenstein persona. The Brides' 1978 album, Funker Walk, was produced by Clinton and earned the act a Record World, a magazine that was like Billboard as terms of a music trade publication of the time. Record World gave them an award for Best New R&B Group, beating nominees that included the Pointer Sisters. With a band that included guitarist Blackbird McKnight, the Brides began opening shows for P-Funk, including their debut at Hollywood Starwood that yours truly was fortunate enough to attend. I was shoulder to shoulder in that small sweatbox of a club, swaying in unison 3 to 4 hours with fellow funketeers to a glorious groove-a-thon that was among the most unforgettable concert experiences of my life. Produced and written by Clinton and Bootsy Collins, the Brides' big hit was Disco to Go, which had begun life as a live Bootsy's rubber band vamp that was pure funk and anything but disco. With lyrics that seriously funk up Old MacDonald, this slamming track brims with all the winning waves of the very best of the P and reached number 7 R&B. It's time to throw your P-Funk sign high in the air and declare the Mothership Connection is here.
Chicks to do that chicken pigs would pay the price of work.
And old MacDonald would do the
disco, you know? Dog.
The mothership connection is here. The mothership connection is here. The mothership connection is here. The mothership connection is here.
The same year the Brides of FUNKNSTUFF emerged, it became evident that there were money and credit tensions escalating within the P-Funk camp that led to some members of the collective splintering into their own acts. That included singer-guitarist Glenn Goines and drummer Jerome Braley. Originally called Eclipse and led by Glenn's brother, Kevin Goines, the 10-piece band out of the Plainsville, New Jersey area came to be known as Quasar. With Glenn Goines, who produced and arranged the group's music and was widely considered one of the greatest male vocalists ever, tragically passing away from Hodgkin's lymphoma at only 24 years of age during its recording, Quasar's self-titled 1978 debut would become its only album. Adding to the band's hard luck story, the original recordings were lost and the songs had to be hastily recut for release. Nevertheless, it was a strong record. In particular, the first few songs were explosive, including the hit lead single, Funk and Roll, Dancing in the Funk Shine. The song's hook contains a chant, Funk Get Ready to Go, Funk Get Ready to Roll, which was also heard in Funkadelic's song, Cholly, that came out just weeks apart. Who copied who, we may never know. What is for certain is that Quasar's Funk and Roll, which rolled to number 11 R&B, is one mother of a jam that will forever bask in the funk shine.
Put your hands together, mama. Clap your hands. Make me dance. I put your hands together. especially in the summertime, mama.
Hey, you mother!
Funk and roll. Gonna give you a common cold.
Classic artists. That's how we do it here at Modern Retro Radio.
Lenny Kravitz has just released his 11th studio album.
Got some 311 here for you here on Modern Retro Radio. Here is the ever-enduring pop genius, Beck. You know, a lot of McCartney fans out there are saying that Egypt Station is up there with his best work.
Giving you the latest from Sheryl Crow.
Here's Bruce Springsteen's 2007 track, Radio Nowhere.
Lindsey Buckingham, Christine McVie.
Here's Marilyn Manson. This is Duran Duran and Dance Phobia.
Here's a rocker from Sting.
This is Garbage, a song called Blood for Poppies.
Here's U2 with Volcano.
Robert Cray, he's channeling Al Green.
Better known as Chaka Khan. Here's her new single.
Brand new music from Parliament Funkadelic. Back in the 1980s and 1990s, we knew him as Terrence Trent D'Arby.
This is Taylor Dane.
You know that group, Foo Fighters?
I'm vaguely familiar with them, yeah.
Yeah, well, you know, they have a song, and it's called Never Ending Sigh.
And Lisa Stansfield is back and sounding just as good as she ever has.
The new album from Slash, Phil Collins covers the Four Tops.
Metallica's 2016 double album, Hardwired to Self-Destruct. Music from Cher. That's some 2018 music from the great band Cake.
Here we got Aerosmith with Beyond Beautiful.
Next up is the greatest song that Chaka Khan never did. The most convincingly authentic Chaka-esque vocals anyone had heard up until that point came from the pipes of Toni Smith. She belted out and co-wrote the biggest hit of jazz trumpeter Tom Brown's career. Influenced by Freddie Hubbard and recording early on with Lonnie Smith, Brown achieved considerable R&B crossover success from 1979 to 1989. That included funky tracks like Thighs High, Grip Your Hips and Move, Rockin' Radio, Cruisin', and Let's Dance, all of which I recommend. A commercial pilot, Brown largely dropped out of the music scene by the late 1980s, but he came back in 1994 with a renewed commitment to more straight-up jazz material. The pick here is from his second album in 1980, titled Love Approach. It's a memoir to the musical hotbed Jamaica neighborhood in the New York City borough of Queens, where he was born and raised. The festive and playful Funkin' for Jamaica pays tribute to that legacy. Although, as I mentioned during a previous special, naive West Coasters like myself were confused as to why a song about a Caribbean island favored funk over reggae. Jamaica funk, that's what it is, and it camped out atop the R&B chart for 5 wonderful weeks.
Go ahead, take it to the cosmos. I said, I got the cosmos. Get free. Going down 160 Fifth Street, passing that ball.
jumping up and down. Say, Teddy Boo, the alley you. Don't hit me in my best song of the night. And I seen Chet, man. I just came to some kid, Chet, man.
What's up with Chet?
Hey, man, he grabbed the street by the tail of all. And spinning around and cracked the back and jumped up and down and hit the jet. Oh!
Last July, we lost a great one, vocalist, bassist, Michael Henderson. During the early 1960s, at just 13 years old, he played sessions with the Fantastic Four, Detroit Emeralds, Billy Preston, and other Motown acts. He also later toured with Stevie Wonder and Aretha Franklin before joining Miles Davis. He played and toured with Davis for 7 years before connecting with drummer, producer Norman Connors, a match that resulted in soul love ballad classics like Valentine Love and You Are My Starship. Henderson parlayed those successes into his own record deal that yielded hits like Take Me, I'm Yours. But he was also known to take penetrating plunges into the funk. Like so many others, he was influenced and inspired by P-Funk, and his biggest hit basically lifted the groove of Parliament's Motor Booty Affair album closer, Deep. He added a brain-staining hook and his own P-inspired lunacy and catchphrases, including, sometimes you feel like a nut, sometimes you don't, for the goofy, yet intense, wide receiver. Get ready to do your best end zone dance.
Let's see. Up close and personal. Good evening, Marvin. See, you're not half the man you used to be. Look at that gut. Pick up your shoes. Be a man, be a man. And you said you'd be first.
Girls and boys living in the city with your sunroof, your hat looks real pretty. Out for the moon, one 40 nickel double swing. Oh, the hot dogs, hot dogs. Doing sit-ups. Come on, baby, let me show you my chin-ups.
love you.
The next selection is from one of my all-time favorite female vocalists and the most commanding and legitimate so-called blue-eyed soul woman singer ever. Born in Venice, California, Mary Christine Brockert was also a gifted musician, composer, arranger, and producer who became famous as Tina Marie, a.k.a. Lady T. That moniker was given to her by longtime collaborator and friend Rick James. Marie, who once appeared as a child actor on TV's The Beverly Hillbillies, recorded unreleased material with several different producers before being spotted by her Motown label mate, James. He had bypassed producing Diana Ross to instead work with her. He got her career off to a fast start with a wild and peaceful 1979 debut album that included James duetting with her on the raucous Sucker for Your Love. She would go on to cultivate a devoted following and notch several R&B hits before passing on in 2010 at just 54. But it was Marie's sophomore effort, Lady T, in 1980 that led off with the blisteringly funky bass-plucking Smoker chosen here. Composed by Marie and Richard Rudolph, widower of the magnificent multi-octave singer Minnie Riperton, Behind the Groove manages to be fierce, soaring, and ethereal all at once. It's time to head to Lady T's version of Xanadu.
Oh, hey, baby.
Oh, yeah?
Let me take you to Xanadu.
Oh, where is that?
Behind the Groove.
Well, all right.
Come to the party.
Slave, one of the baddest funk bands to ever do it, was formed in 1975 by trumpeter, multi-instrumentalist, composer, producer, and arranger Steve Washington, who at 15 had toured with his uncle, Ralph Pee Wee Middlebrooks of the Ohio Players, and trombonist Floyd Miller. Despite success, Slave underwent many personnel changes that led to some members, even Washington himself, to move on with other bands. However, current and former bandmates continued to collaborate on each other's projects. One of the most successful was Aura, in which chief architect Washington recruited recent Slave addition star Lena Young on vocals and singer-guitarist Kurt Jones as featured performers. The act annually produced albums from 1980 to 1985, with its biggest hit being the sophisticated funk of Make Up Your Mind. However, it's Aura's first hit that is the choice here. Opening with a nasty plucked bass run backed by a bubbling synth, Are You Single cooks with gas and bringing vocal group level singing and harmonies to a band of musicians capable of generating genuine heavy on the one rhythms can result in unbeatable funk. At the head of that class is Parliament and the Temptations, but others like the OJs, Dramatics, and Five Special have tread there as well. Thanks to the imminent track, you can add the Chi-Lites to that list. Formed at Chicago's Hyde Park High School in 1959 and led by lead singer-musician soul-songwriter Eugene Record, the group's major early 1970s hits were the mellow Have You Seen Her and Oh Girl. Between 1969 to 74, the Chi-Lites enjoyed 11 top 10 R&B hits and charted 21 pop songs. The group's eventual accolades include inductions into the Vocal Group Hall of Fame and R&B Music Hall of Fame, and receiving a star in Hollywood's Walk of Fame. More than two decades after they got their start, the Chi-Lites demonstrated their enduring relevance by delivering not only their funkiest offering ever, but among the thickest grooves of the 1980s. A sweltering salute to the seductive charms of the female form, Bottoms Up, bounced up to number 7 R&B in 1983.
That bottom.
Hey, from the top to the bottom, we have shuffled through another murderous row of killer funk tunes. It breezed by fast, but hopefully these dirty dozen slammer jammers have twiddled and titillated your groove receptors to induce your earhole to climax and your booty to go far beyond the call of duty. At least until we meet up again for the next round of Dr. GX's diabolical dispatching of the most percussive and explosive funk grooves ever assembled and audibilized by humankind. Thank you for paying attention as I humbly seek to serve and protect funk's pleasure principle. Hit me up directly to ask for a copy of this show, share feedback, input for future shows, or just to talk music. Be sure to stay in tune with this special frequency as I honor my pledge to continue to royally funk you up. Lastly, dive deeper into most of the artists heard here by checking out episodes of the Truth and Rhythm Show. As always, this is Scott Dr. Jigs Qualfine saying, keep on vibrating to the rhythm of the one.
Father Snake! Father Snake! Roots is great! Crack and break!